not so far away, lived a lonely young boy. Lonely he was, for he lived without a true love of his own. One summer night, when the fireflies were blinking like stars in the heavens, the lonely young boy wished for something that would change his life forever. With all his heart, he wished, he hoped, he longed for a happy ending.
If you don't have anyone to call your own, you wonder when your story will begin. Must I face another day all alone? When will I find a place where I fit in?
Happy ending.
Who are you?
I'm your fairy godmother.
Miriam Shor is my fairy godmother?
Well, I used to be a good Christian bitch. But, now I'm just a bitch. But a bitch in a fabulous dress. Check this out. And now with wings. And these are my backup singers, the goddammits. There's Flora and Fauna and Effie. And we're here to tell you, you're not the only one looking for a happy ending. The baker's wife might seem unfriendly, but underneath it all, she's sweet.
She's sweet.
It's just she's got a muffin that no one else will eat. The butcher's butcher in the village might push and shove you in the street. But the truth is he needs someone who can help him with his meat. Fairy tales deserve a happy ending.
Fairy tales deserve a happy ending.
So it's always good to lend a hand.
So it's always good to lend a hand.
If only we all have friends to make us happy. God damn it.
Your wicked stepsisters are grouchy and have a knack for starting brawls. But it's just because they're yearning to see some royal balls. And though the room might seem quite normal, it's giving off a dewy light,
which means there's magic in the moon. You can find your true love in my enchanted book of fairy tales. Isn't it magical?
No, it's a book, not a Kindle. You open it. Kids. Give it a try. Chapter one.
Jack was such a lucky guy. He climbed his beanstalk to the sky. He reached the top and had to gawk. The giant had a big fat...
Happy Father's Day, everyone! Like that? Try chapter two.
The little mermaid met a prince, and she's been crying ever since. The prince was rude and very blunt, and said she had a really fishy...
Chapter three.
The emperor had brand new clothes, but was nude from crown to toes. His arms were weak and oh so heinous. He didn't even bleach his.
That is
you know what I'm talking about.
I didn't know you were into scat.
Don't judge.